Hello, I'm Mandy, the 2nd of October. I hope everyone's had a good weekend. As for myself and many other people, we had a truly wonderful time at St. Luke's homecoming service yesterday. Our opening prayer. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose mercies are new every day, at the start of this new working week, let the radiance of the Holy Spirit renew our lives, warm our hearts, give light to our minds, and help us to apply wisdom at all time. Amen. Today's readings are from Ezekiel chapter 10, verses 1 to 19, and Psalm 71. It doesn't matter wherever you are travelling in this country, it isn't long before you come across a castle. Now, they may be in very varied states of repair, but they are castles, even if it's only the foundations and a couple of bricks which are still standing. And the history behind these buildings is always interesting. Why was it built in the first place? Who lived in it? And has it changed hands over the years? As the backstory is revealed, there is usually at least one occasion when it has had to be defended against attack. Now, it's very rare for people just to leave a castle when they see an army approaching. They at least want to put up a defence rather than just leaving an empty building which their enemies can walk into. In this chapter, Ezekiel is receiving a godly vision linked to the Jerusalem temple. God is there, and it has been known as his home since it was completed in Solomon's time. However, in the vision, Ezekiel sees God leaving the temple behind and empty. What's this all about? Surely God isn't resigned to the fact that there is a stronger power, because there isn't. God is almighty. So what else has gone on to lead to this taking place? For several years and through different people, God has been warning and advising the Israelites. And, quite simply, they are just taking God for granted, whilst also ignoring him. The people want God's protection, but they don't want to do the right thing and follow godly guidance. Now, God's decision to leave the temple isn't on the spur of the moment. He's not just having a bad day. God has attempted to help them onto the right track through the warnings issued, and now feels that he is left with no other option. Our next prayer. Almighty and eternal God, to whom we must all give account, guide with your spirit the people of the place where we live, that we may be faithful to the mind of Christ and seek to enrich the common life in everything we do, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. For our prayer points today, let's pray for all who have been affected by that terrible school bus crash on the Wirral. Pray for an end to knife crime, and pray for any victims of it. And pray for people who are suffering from abuse on social media. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I think I now need to go to help finish tidying up in the St. Luke's premises after yesterday. And our blessing. The goodness of the Father go with you. The love of the Saviour lead you. The peace of the Holy Spirit guide you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you today and forevermore.